there are white niggers. I've seen a lot of white niggers in my time.
There was a time I could mention the names of William Lloyd Garrison or Frederick Douglass, and people would know exactly who I'm talking about. But that was 170 years ago. And along with our hats and our coats, we've hung up our values and our morals. Same morals that have made America great. I can't help but believe that maybe there's some return to that. But those names are all but been erased in the chronicles of history. There will be a time when I could whisper the names of Stowe or Madam C.J. Walker, and someone might dare to remember them. But that was less than 100 years ago. And those names are about as foreign to us as Plato's cave. I could possibly remember or say a name like Rosa Parks, maybe Senator Everett Dirksen, and someone might remember his name. There's been an average of 20 years has passed since these souls have walked the earth, and we still have yet to replace them. We ought to be convicted that we've allowed the narrative of republicanism to be rewritten. Like possums, we've rolled over and we've played dead, hoping and begging that the dangers of liberalism will pass us by. Like laughing hyenas, We've ran away from the responsibility of communities that have been drenched in poverty and inequality, all because we've been too afraid to be courageous. But I'm here to remind you of who we are. We're the sons and daughters of abolitionists. Men and women who gave their lives to fight against slavery. But make no mistake about it, slavery has returned. And she is more vicious than ever before, because this time she is colorblind. 31%. 31% of white Americans are welfare recipients. 33% of black Americans have fallen for the same rules, and 28% of the Latino community has believed the lie that the government can take care of you from the cradle to the grave. All the while losing their humanity. So when Trump talks about the lies that the Democrat Party has told and the failed policies, both in economics, education, and crime, your heart should be stirred with passion and strength to do something about it. We pranced around in our arrogance. We have pranced around in our arrogance, believing that just maybe something will happen without us doing anything. Just not the case. With the growing population of Hispanics and the decline of the black populace, Jim Crow laws, like the Clintons' war on drugs, has incarcerated millions of black men. Has left millions of women without husbands. Millions of children fatherless. The reason why 1.5 million black men are not in our communities is because of the war on drugs. That's the Democrats' full-out assault against the black man. It is their emasculation of everything that the culture of blacks stand for. They have been emasculated, an entire culture. What will we do about it? So let me tell you this. If you come to this rally thinking that it's a revival, this is not a revival. This is a place where you get armed up to fight. So when Trump starts talking about going into the inner city communities and changing the rhetoric, when he talks about going into the inner city communities and offering a hand up instead of a hand out, I can't help but listen and know that it's the truth. So then we must engage. We must engage in the areas of education by offering charter schools and academies to teach our children. We must engage. We must engage in the area of economics by empowering entrepreneurs not to be job seekers, but job creators. We must engage. We must engage in the areas of crime to make sure that we are not pulling men from homes. We must engage. 94% of black Americans vote Democrat. And half a century and to no avail. If you believe that they are sleeping, you are sadly mistaken. There would be no greater time than now for us to go into these communities and teach them freedom and economic independence. So now you stand at the precipice of change, and times like these are monumental. Must not allow our people to fail. We must not allow the return of slavery. We must prove President Johnson wrong. He thought that the black community would sell their birthright for a bowl of soup. For 200 years, he was sadly mistaken. So let's send a message from Texas to all of America that this is the port of Abraham Lincoln and we will not be divided. Trump! 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 God bless Texas. God bless America. And God bless you all. Thank you.